हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय प्लेलिस्ट ऑफ एनाटॉमी फ्रॉम स्नेल। बीडी 84 से मैं ऑलरेडी अपर लिम की एनाटॉमी और दूसरे रीजन्स की भी एनाटॉमी कंप्लीट करवा चुका हूं, बट ऑन स्टूडेंट्स डिमांड एंड रिक्वेस्ट्स आई हैव नाउ स्टार्टेड एनाटॉमी फ्रॉम स्नेल। अपर लिम हम कर रहे हैं एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन द ऑस्टियोलॉजी ऑफ अपर लिम। एंड आज जो बोन हमने एक्चुअली कवर करनी है दैट इज द क्लेविकल। सो दैट्स द फर्स्ट बोन दैट वी विल डू टुडे एंड देन वी विल कंटिन्यू अवर डिस्कशन फ्रॉम हेयर। सो अपर लिम इज अ कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ द अपेंडिकुलर स्केलेटन। द बोन्स अपेंडिकुलर स्केलेटन इज ऑब्वियसली द स्केलेटन वेयर यू हैव गॉट द लिम्स एंड दिस इज पार्ट। अपर लिम इज ऑब्वियसली योर अपर लिम एंड यू नो वॉट दैट मीन्स। इफ दिस इज यू, दीज आर योर लोअर लिम्स एंड दीज आर योर अपर लिम्स, राइट? द बोन्स विच आर इंक्लूडेड in the upper limb and that we have to cover all the way through includes number one, clavicle, which we will do today. Then there is the shoulder blade, which is the scapula. Then you have humerus, radius and ulna. Then the carpal bones, metacarpal bones and phalanges. So if you let me find a diagram for you, so this is the bone that we will do today, that is known as clavicle. Okay, so clavicle basically connects the sternal area with the rest of the upper limb. So it's a very important connecting bone. And then at the back, so you see this bone at the back, this is also called the blade, shoulder blade. This is the scapula and this is the bone which provides attachment area to this bone of your arm, which is known as humerus. And then humerus is connected later on with the radius and ulna. Then there are wrist bones, then there are meta, which are the carpal bones, then there are metacarpals, and then your fingers, the phalanges. So that's the kind of makeup for your upper limb. Okay, the clavicle and scapula form the shoulder girdle. The word girdle basically means ke ye pura ek ring banta hai yahan pe. So if you look at the diagram here, ye ek side ka, so suppose this is the right side and ye right side ka clavicle or scapula hai, isi tarah left side par bhi clavicle or scapula hoga. So combined together, this is then has a specific name and this is what we call the shoulder girdle or the pectoral girdle. Then there is a humerus which defines the arm, जिसमें आपके डोले शोले होते हैं, biceps वगैरह, और उसके नीचे फिर then there is forearm, जिसमें radius और ulna दो bones हैं. So arm में कौन सी bone है? Humerus. Forearm में कौन सी bone है? Radius and ulna. फिर जो wrist की bone है, these are the carpal bones. और फिर जो hand में bones हैं, these are the metacarpals. और फिर जो fingers में bones हैं, वो आपके phalanges, right? Now this section provides a comprehensive description of the bones of the upper limb, their significant features, rather than relegating learning this material to a painful exercise in rote memorization of meaningless words. Try to understand the terminology, right? So for example, what is the difference between a tubercle, which is small in size, than tuberosity, which is much bigger? So if this is a bone and this is what you see, it's a tubercle. But if this is what you see, this is a tuberosity. Okay. In order to better understand the application of anatomy, and I so like this ke inhone yahan pe ye mention kiya hai ke sometimes anatomy ki bone osteology ke features, inki muscle attachments, it becomes a painful exercise to do. Bada hi mushkil hota hai. Students rata lagate rehte hain ke yahan par flexor pollicis longus is jagah lagega. Ye dekhen ji, aapko ye is tarah se padhna hai ki cheez aapko samajh mein aaye, muscles ke action samajh mein aaye aur uski functional implication aapko pata ho ki agar fracture hoga to kis jagah hoga, kaun si nerve damage hogi. So you have to understand and read anatomy in a smart way rather than a painful exercise, and I like it ki Snell ne isko mention kiya hai. Most importantly, ask yourself functional questions when you examine the bones, such as the following: is it a right or the left elbow? Very important. You should at least be able to identify ke jo aap humerus dekh rahe ho, wo right side ki hai, left side ki hai. What articulates with this structure? What attaches to this structure? Is it palpable? Bahar se body mein agar kisi ko feel kare to koi subcutaneous part hai, koi feel hone wala part hai. Can this structure be identified if we do radiology? X-ray mein nazar aayega. Are there many important neurovascular relations? Koi agar fracture hua to nerve damage. These are all what I call the practical questions. Practical questions. Rather than picking up a blue color and marking the bone ki ji is jagah par aapka subscapularis attach hoga, aur examiner agar aapse kahe ki oh ye to aapne zyada niche tak bana diya bhai, ye upar rukna. Yaar, this is all painful things, okay? So examiners ko bhi ye baat samajhni chahiye, teachers ko bhi, as a student aapko bhi samajhni chahiye. You have to understand the practicality of the things, okay? So with this concept, let's just start clavicle today, and this video will focus on clavicle. It's also known as the collarbone. I mean, you have seen many people. So this bone here, you can imagine, so here will be the neck of the person and here will be the head of the person. So this bone is the collarbone, all right, because this is where your collar sits. Also is known as the beauty bone in some areas, okay? It's located between the sternum and the scapula. So understand this. This is easy to understand. Going back to the diagram, I'll actually be going up and down, back and forth, taki aapko diagram mein dikhata rahun. So here we have the sternum in the center of your chest, and this is the scapula. So between the sternum and the scapula, you've got this clavicle. Okay. Right. So it lies horizontally. It's a horizontal bone, and it is roughly S-shaped and resembles a large old-style key. It is indeed S-shaped. If you see, somewhat S ban raha is tarah se, right? So it's a curved bone basically. Abhi hum dekhte hain ki uski curvings kya hain. The clavicle forms a light strut that connects the upper limb to the thorax and allows the limb to move freely to the trunk. So basically it's a connection jisme ye pura upper limb jo hai, it is connected to the thorax by this little bone which is known as clavicle. So it's a connection between the thorax and the rest of the upper limb. It is the first bone to begin ossification. Important point, ye yaad hona chahiye aapko. The clavicle is subcutaneous, so you can easily feel it. Aap apna clavicle bhi feel kar sakte hain. You can actually neck area pe aap yahan apna clavicle feel kar sakte hain. So it is subcutaneous bone. It is not a bone which is deeply buried inside the muscles, okay? Now there are two ends. Obviously one end is towards the sternum and the other end is towards the shoulder blade, scapula if you like. So again, if you look at this diagram, this is what we have got. There is an external end which actually makes a joint with the sternum. Then there is an acromial end which is like here, okay? So the external end is blunt, thickened, proximal and medial end of the clavicle. It articulates with the clavicular notch of the sternum and they make a joint there, which is a compound synovial joint, which means it has multiple synovial cavities, and they also have an articular disc. So this is the joint which is formed between the sternum and clavicle. Remember, this end is also called the medial end. Obviously it would be, because anything closer to the midline is medial, anything away from the midline is lateral. So this will be the lateral end. This is called medial end. You either call it medial or proximal end, okay? Now jo long bones hoti hain, jo aise vertical bones hain, unme aasan hai. Jo upar ki taraf hai wo proximal end hai, jo dur hai ye wala distal end hoga humerus ka. Lekin is bone ka issue ye hai ki ye flat padi hui hai horizontal. To isme aapko ye pata lagana padega, yaad rakhna padega ki the medial end is known as the proximal end and the lateral end is known as the distal end, okay? Now the acromial extremity, which is the lateral end or the distal end, is kind of flattened and it articulates with the acromion process of the scapula. The conoid tubercle is a small roughened elevation on the inferior surface near the acromial end. This serves as an attachment area for the conoid ligament, which is part of the coracoclavicular ligament. So all this is all important information. This is the lateral end, the tubercle, you have to remember, and it forms a joint with the scapula, right? Clavicle doesn't come in direct contact with humerus. Many students think this way, but it doesn't. The important muscle and ligament attached to the clavicle are shown in figure 3.1 and 3.2. Now this is how mostly Snell deals with the bones. This is how it does it, okay? Now BD 84 jin logon ne mere sath padhi hai, those students know, and maybe you are listening to lecture of Snell, but aapne bhi ho sakta hai mere sath BD 84 ke lectures dekhe ho. BD 84 tells every feature of the bone, obviously in great detail, ke how is the bone looking like. So if you are having a bone in your hand, what side of the bone is convex, what side of the bone is concave, how does it ossify, what are the muscle attachments. But Snell zyada tar ye karta hai ki wo in points pe heavily focus nahi karta, diagram mein bata dete ki bhai ye diagram dekh lo, attachments yaad karni hai to kar lo. So if you go to this diagram, for example, this is how they are explaining. There are two parts. Part A is the superior surface, so this is how you are looking these clavicle from above, and this is the inferior. So ulta kar denge to inferiorly aise nazar aayega, right? So if you look here again, assume this is the right side. I can see this is the lateral part of the bone. This is the medial part because ye sternum ki taraf hai, and I can also see ki ye medial side se it is convex, and then laterally it is a little concave front se. So this is convex here, concave here. Okay, and on the superior surface there are two muscles attached, pec major and sternocleidomastoid, which can pull the bone up if needed. And and red things basically mean the origin, and this basically bluish thing means the insertion of the muscle. Okay, so deltoid arises from the superior surface as well. If you look at the inferior, deltoid ka origin continue kar raha, there is subclavius which can pull the bone downward, insertion hai, origin of pec major. This is the origin of pec major. It continues on the inferior surface as well. So, and this green bit is telling you okay, jo jo joints ban rahe hain, jis tubercle ki humne baat ki thi, which gives attachment to the coracoclavicular ligament. So green bits are the capsular ligamentous joint indications. Okay, so if you want to spend some time on the diagram, you'll have to remember the attachments. Okay, clavicle is also one of the bones which is easily fractured because subcutaneous hai, bilkul skin ke niche padi hui hai, to accident mein it gets fractured very routinely. Okay, balki yahan pe alag se heading bhi diye hai unhone clinical notes mein. The clavicle is a strut that holds the arm laterally, so it can move freely on the trunk. It is the sole link between the upper limb and the axilla, very important point. So on one side it has the upper limb, on the other side it has the thorax, which is part of the axilla skeleton. So it transmits all the force from the upper limb to the trunk. Unfortunately, because of its position, which means subcutaneous, it is easily exposed to trauma. It is the most commonly fractured bone of the body. Imagine, the fracture usually occurs as a result of the fall on the shoulder on outstretched hand. Aise aap gir gaye, zameen pe aapka haath pada, clavicle gayi. Because ye jo sara weight hai aapka, jo is haath pe pada, ye transmit ho raha hai to the thorax and the your skeletal axial skeleton. So is pe kafi pressure hai, to ye fracture ho jati hai. The fracture usually occurs, ye ho gayi baat hamari, the force is transmitted along the clavicle, which breaks at its weakest point, which is the junction of the middle and the outer third. So if you look at the diagram, so divided into three thirds, middle and the outer third ka junction is the most vulnerable portion. After the fracture, the lateral fragment is depressed by weight of the arm. Obviously ye jo lateral fragment hai, jab ye fracture pura yahan pe upper limb attached hai na, to weight of the arm ki wajah se it's gonna go depress the lateral fragment. Okay, or pec major bhi yahan pe usko khench ke niche le aayega. So if you look at you know, the anatomy, things will become more clear ki kahan insertion hai kahan nahi, right? The medial end is tilted upward because sternocleidomastoid muscle laga hua. So if you look at the diagram again here, superior side pe we have sternocleidomastoid. Imagine this is fractured. Now this is a different bit and this is a different bit. So sternocleidomastoid tends to pull the medial fragment of the fractured bone upward. The close relationship of the supraclavicular nerves to the clavicle may result in the involvement of callus formation after fracture of the bone, and this may entrap the nerve and it will cause pain in the side of the neck. So this is a common phenomena, right? Now if we talk about clavicular compression of the brachial plexus, subclavian artery and subclavian vein, this is also an important clinical correlate. The interval between the clavicle and the first rib in some patients may become narrowed. So obviously if you look at the diagram here, we have the clavicle here and then we have got the ribs starting. So that's the first rib and here's the interval. So sometimes, so this is already so close, and sometimes it can be so narrow of an interval that the space is so little, and this can then compress upon the structures. So this will compress the nerves and blood vessels. Okay, and we will discuss this later on. So that's all about the important bits related to clavicle that you should not, cannot forget. Okay, so I'll see you in another video very soon. Take care of yourself.